Welcome back, guys, and in this lesson we'll be looking at Linux PWD command and also the Linux LS command, that's the list command. Now you might see on my screen the prompt is different. I'm connected to the server as the root user and the IP address or the host name is different. Do not worry about it because I'm using a completely different server from this session onwards. So if the Linux prompt is not matching with what you have on your system, nothing to worry at all. Alright, now that I'm connected to the server with the root user, just type this command PWD. This is the present working directory, and you can see that the current directory that I am in is /root. That means this slash is also known as root, but it is a file system. We already know that root file system is the one from where it all starts. All the file structures and directories start with the root. That's the root file system. And then we have a folder called as root, and that's where we are in right now. And we also know that as per the Linux prompt, we know the symbol called as tilde. And with this symbol, we can say that we are already at the parent or the home location of the root user. That means whenever you log into the server with root user, you will always land onto this location. That's /root. All right. So that's our first command. And guys, I want you to remember this PWD command by heart it, because this is the most used command and you must be aware like which location you are in and where you are trying to execute the command. PWD, make sure if you are anytime confused where you are in the Linux system, it is good to use the PWD command. Even with our upcoming sessions, I'll be using PWD command a lot of times so that it will be a revision for you. For now, PWD is present working directory. It will show you where exactly you are in the Linux operating system. The next command that we have is ls command, that is the list command. Now that I type ls and hit enter, it will show us what all data we have in this location. That means /root folder contains this zip file. Also guys, in your case you might not see anything if there is nothing on the server. That's perfectly okay, but ls command will always show you whatever is there in the current directory that you can find using the PWD command. There is also another version of the ls command that I personally use, and I also recommend you all to use, that is ls -lrt. Now if you see this command, what it does is, along with the file which is there in the location that you are in, it will also give you more details about the permissions, about the owner, about the group that it belongs, what is the size of the file, like when it was created, and the year, right? So that's the file details. And with this command, you get more data about the file. And you see this ls-l is the listing of more details about your files in the current folder. RT is reverse sort using time. That means anytime when you look at the output of this command, the latest file with time will be always at the bottom. So that way it makes it easy for you to look at the files and you always have the access to the latest file. You might also see a lot of other versions of ls-ltr or lart. People might use different versions. Do not worry at all, because after hyphen, we do have a lot of parameters that you can use, but I highly recommend you guys to stick to this one for now, and this should be enough for you to continue with your Linux learning. That's all guys for now, and I'll see you quickly in the next lecture.